Hey, shalom, shalom, mishpokah. Welcome to another edition of Ray Bash's Ramblings. I'm your host, Rabbi Yehuda Ben Shomer. Here lately, I have received a lot of requests and a lot of emails asking the question about such things as black Jews. I'm not going to go into all the documents or evidence or lack thereof and all the arguments, blah, 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 about black Jews and everything. Let me put it to you this way. Do I believe that there's black Jews? Yes. Do I believe that all black people are Jews? No. Those people who profess this black Jews, black Judaism, that they're the true Israel, the real Israel, they're nothing more than the counterpart to Nazis and white supremacists. These black Jews are black supremacists. That's all there is to it. Now, let me explain to you why I believe that there is such a thing as black Jews. Not only has there been DNA evidence linking some black people in Africa, some black tribes in Africa, with the Cohen gene, which would link them to the Levitical priesthood. But, you know, think of it this way. Noah had three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. It's been theorized that these three sons were actually triplets, and these triplets were born with different amounts and shades of melanin within their bodies. So that would mean, scientifically, if this was true and if this was to work out, scientifically, this means that Noah and his wife and Adam and Eve and possibly everybody else up to this point were black. This may shock people. This may make a lot of people gasp, and other people may say, yeah, right on. But Noah and his wife were black. They had three sons, and if it's true that they were triplets, born with different shades of melanin, this would be a scientific explanation where the various races come from. You have Ham, who was black, just like his parents. You have Shem, who was kind of the middle of the road. He was a lighter shade of black. He had less melanin. And then you had Japheth, who even had more, of a lack of melanin within his skin, and he was born what we would call Caucasian or white. So Ham is the father of all the Hamitic races, usually those that are black and in Africa. And then you have Shem, who is the father of all the Hebraic and Arabic peoples, Semitic peoples. Then you have Japheth, who was the father of all the Caucasian and Asian light-skinned races that are found in the world. Now, due to the two captivities, you have the Babylonian captivity, which the tribe of Judah and Levi and a little bit of Benjamin was taken into Babylonian captivity. They returned, most of them returned, some of them didn't, but they returned, and they are who we recognize as Jewish people today because they are identifiable, they are traceable. You also have those that were taken off to an Assyrian captivity. Those that were taken into Assyrian captivity were the what we call the Lost Ten Tribes. They were the other tribes of Israel. Now, the majority of them have not returned from exile, have not returned from Assyrian captivity. Therefore, they have assimilated and have gotten lost into the surrounding peoples where they were taken off into exile and dispersed to. Now, because of these captivities, you have intermarriage, you have intermingling of races, and therefore it is very possible, very probable, and it is a matter of fact that now you have people who are Hebrews or Jews from all different colors, races, languages, and people groups around the world. And I think God purposely allowed this to happen, so that the family of God could be one. Let me read to you something. I'm not sure if I totally agree with it, but I thought this was interesting nonetheless. Let me read it. It says, according to Eliezer Shulman, in his book, The Sequence of Events in the Old Testament, Abraham was born in the year 1948 from creation, approximately 2050 BCE. His son of promise, Yitzhak, Isaac, was born 100 years later in 2048 BCE from creation, 2048 from creation, approximately 1950 BCE. This places the birth of Yitzhak some 3,950 years from the present time. Using 25 years as a generational means that today we are 158 generations removed from Abraham. Using 40 years per generation still removes us nearly 100 generations. The number of ancestors for any single person increases exponentially with each generation. Two parents, four grandparents, eight great-grandparents, etc. Going back only 40 generations yields a potential of over 1 trillion direct descendants from a single individual. This number far exceeds the total number of people who ever lived on Earth since the beginning of time. With such immense numbers involved, it should be no surprise that we are all more closely related than we may have ever imagined. Abraham lived for nearly 4,000 years ago. Surely, in the statistical model is anywhere near correct, every person on Earth could conceivably be descended from Abraham, just as the Nivirikou theory suggests. Equally possible is the theory that every person on Earth could be descended from the 12 sons of Yaakov, the progenitors of the children of Israel. This is from an article called Abraham's Math, taken from Hebrew Roots, issue 2-2, page 20. Now, I don't necessarily 100% agree with this, because I believe that there are pure Gentile stock in the world, seeing as the majority of the peoples of the world were Gentile anyway, and God chose a small remnant to be called Hebrews, to be called Jews. So, I just thought I'd throw that in there, because it is possible, because of the Assyrian captivity, there are people that are walking this earth now who are actually Hebrews and don't even know it and have no clue. There is a documentary put out by A&E, by Jacob, the guy who does The Naked Archaeologist, Jacob, and I can't remember his last name. But anyway, he has done a documentary where he's gone back to the scriptures and through archaeology trying to identify and find the lost in tribes. He's done pretty much that. There's still some tribes that have not been found, but he's done a good job at identifying these lost tribes within the people groups around the world. Just be very careful of the whole black Hebrew thing. I think there's a lot of misinformation, a lot of biased, jaded, doctored information that is basically nothing short of propaganda. The same style of propaganda that the Nazis and the communists and even today the white supremacists brought out. It's just, you know, from a black standpoint and viewpoint. Just to sum it up really quick, do I believe that they are black Jews in the world? Yes, absolutely. Do I believe that all black people are Jews? No, I don't. So thanks for watching. Hopefully this answers a lot of people's questions. Shalom and Shavuot Tov. Bye-bye.